In this video, I will show you how to perform a power steering fluid flush on a BMW E36. I will be detailing the full process of flushing all the fluid, rather than just from the reservoir like a lot of other tutorials. This process takes longer, but it's definitely worth it to keep the power steering system in good condition. So here's what you'll need to complete this project. A jack. For this, I find the jack next to the spare tyre to be sufficient. A pair of strong jack stands. A few litres of Dexron 3 or higher spec automatic transmission fluid. You could spend more money on synthetic fluid, but really, it's just being used as a hydraulic fluid, so it's not mandatory. Then you will need a fluid pump and hose, a 22mm socket and wrench, and two 14mm crush washers. This part might be different on some BMWs, so check the part number using realoem.com. You will also need some plastic sheeting or a garbage bag, something to protect the belts from the fluid. So the first step is to jack up the front of the car. To do this, place chocks behind the back wheels to avoid any slippage. Then to jack up the first side, we need to remove this jack point cover. You can use a flathead screwdriver to do this. Then lower the jack until it can fit into the jack point hole. Then raise the jack slowly, making sure it's stable, until the jack stand fits underneath the car. Place the jack stand under the circular jacking point and lower the car onto it carefully. Then repeat this process on the other side of the car. Now that the front of the car is raised up, we can begin the flush process. In my case, I needed to remove the air filter from the intake manifold to properly access the power steering reservoir. Then we need to use the plastic sheeting to cover the power steering pump pulley and the main belt near the reservoir. This is important as it will prevent any belt slippage in case the ATF gets spilt onto the belt or the pulley. Then we need to open the power steering fluid reservoir. The fluid in mine was in pretty good shape. It was still dark red in colour. If it's much darker than this though, it's a good idea to replace it. Now we need to remove all the fluid from the reservoir. Use the fluid pump to suck the fluid out into another container. Now we need to remove the fluid from the power steering pump and the rest of the system. To do this, grab an oil pan and a 22mm socket and wrench with a long extension. Then from underneath the car, we need to undo the fluid return hose connection on the bottom of the power steering pump. Place the pan under this bolt, then loosen it some of the way. Fluid will spill out into the pan once it's loose. Next, we need to push the remaining fluid out. Put the key into the ignition to unlock the steering, then turn the wheel slowly to each lock a few times. As you can see, this removes even more old fluid from the system. After the fluid stops coming out from the connection, retighten the bolt. At this stage, I kept the old crush washers in place since I was going to do a second flush before tightening the bolt up for good. Now that all the old fluid is drained out, we can refill the power steering system with the new ATF. You can use a funnel to assist with this process. Simply pour some fluid into the power steering reservoir until it's fairly full. It will take around 500 millilitres or so at this stage. It doesn't matter if it's above the max line of the dipstick, as we aren't turning the car on yet. Once you've done this, turn the steering wheel from lock to lock a couple times. This will move the new fluid through to the pump and steering rack. There will be a little bit of old fluid which mixes with the new, as you can see. Put the lid back on the reservoir, then take it off to check the fluid level. It has dropped towards the minimum mark, as you can see. Add in some more ATF until it's around the full mark. Then with the lid back on, you can take off the plastic covering and put the air filter back in place. Then start the car. We want to quite slowly turn the wheel from lock to lock again. Repeat this 5 or so times. This process circulates the fluid and bleeds most of the air out of the system. The power steering pump may make a few noises as the air is bled. This is normal. Then turn off the engine and check the level in the reservoir. It has gone down again, as you can see. This, in combination with the small bubbles on the fluid surface, means we have bled some of the air out successfully. Since I'm doing a second flush, I stopped here with the bleeding process. Normally, I would repeat the previous step and continue bleeding the system to remove as much air as possible. Now at this point, I was starting my second flush to make the system as clean as possible. I just followed the same steps as the first time, pumping fluid out from the reservoir, then draining the rest into the oil pan, and turning the steering wheel to push it all out. I also removed the bolt entirely from the return hose. Then at this point, as it was getting late, I left the car overnight to drain fully. After cleaning the hose connection and bolt, I got the two crush washers and installed them in place of the old ones, then screwed the bolt back in and tightened it. Keep tightening until you feel the crush washers being crushed. Next, refill the system for the last time, following the same steps as before. Turn the wheel lock to lock a few times with the engine off, then refill the reservoir. Then turn on the engine, turn the wheel another 5 to 10 times, and then refill again, and then repeat those last 3 steps to bleed all the air out. Before finishing up, I went about cleaning around the reservoir with a rag to remove any spilt fluid. Then I wiped over the pump pulley and the main belt. Next, I got some brake cleaner, and with the engine on, sprayed some onto the inside and outside of the belts. I did this to remove any ATF that might have gotten onto the belt, just in case. Then I sprayed degreaser onto the power steering pump and around the reservoir to clean off these components. To finish cleaning, I washed off everywhere I sprayed with the degreaser and brake cleaner, and then dried it all with a cloth. Finally, I lowered the front of the car back to the ground. Now with a fresh lot of fluid in the system, my steering was lighter and smoother. It's recommended to do this procedure every 50 to 60,000 kilometers to keep the power steering system in good shape. Thanks for watching my tutorial on flushing a BMW E36's power steering fluid.